There are a few things that we need to do. One, we need Word of God. Because the Word of God is the mind of God. Can you take time at this time to study the Word of God? Most of the time we have been too busy, even doing other things and trying to make our ends meet, but now we have ample time. Can you take time and read the Word of God? Probably the Lord has given us a retreat so that we may seek Him. Can you please take time to read the Word of God? Have you ever read the whole of Psalms 23, the whole of the book of Psalms? Have you ever completed the book of Proverbs? If you take the book of Proverbs, you can read a chapter every day and you are in 1 month. Can you take time to read the Word of God? Have you ever read the whole of the New Testament? It is important. You can take time together with your family to read the Word of God. Take time to read the Word that may build you. Paul said, let the Word of God dwell in you richly. It is time for us to seek the Lord. After you have read the Word of God, can you also take time, because God has given us this retreat, can you take some time? Every day, if you have never been prayed non-stop for that minute, can you take time every day to pray for that minute non-stop? And if you can, you can also pray for 1 hour. Can you take time to pray? It is time to seek God. This time you seek Him because He can be found. So it is important at this time, instead of being dominated by fear, can you take time to pray? You take time to pray. Because the Bible says, pray without ceasing so that you do not fall into temptation. Because if you don't pray and you only entertain, you only entertain negative information, you are going to give up. Because it is possible right now, because TV has become a very important thing in our lives now. And right now, even I know, by around 4, every one of us is actually waiting for the updates at 4 in the evening. Every time, every day, we are waiting for the update. And if you are not careful, you can be switching from one channel to the other, because you want to update yourself with information. If you are not careful, you are always scrolling your phone to get what is happening in the world. You want to know what is happening and the update. And there are many messages that you are receiving. But I want to tell you, if you are dominated by these stories that you are getting from your WhatsApp, from your Facebook, from the other social media, you can be discouraged and be dominated by fear. But it is time for you to seek God and to read the Word of God. Let the Word of God dwell in you richly. And when you have the Word of God, the Word of God has a very positive message. Because the Word of God tells us, we are more than conquerors. We are not defeated. It is well with us. It is well with our family. It is well with our health. This is the Word of God. Therefore, it is time to take time to read the Word of God. It is time to take time to pray and have time with the Lord. I would also want to tell you another thing that you need. A lot of time we go before the Lord and we talk, we pray in a hurry. After you have prayed, can you also take time to meditate and to be silent before the Lord and you listen to what the Lord is saying? A lot of times we talk to God and we don't listen. Can you take time? During this time, you can take time and you go to a secluded place, probably in your room, and you wait upon the Lord silently, just tuning your mind and you want to hear, and you tell the Lord, now speak to me. Lord, I have been speaking too much. Now speak to me, because our Lord speaks. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. When we were coming to this year, the Lord told me He hears. has a mouth. The Lord has hands, and that is why the Bible says He's able to save. The Lord is able to deliver us. Yes, He's going to speak to you. Can you take time to meditate? To meditate, to wait upon the Lord, so that the Lord may speak to you. Take time to listen to God. So there are two things I've said, that we need to read the Word of God. We need to pray. We also need to meditate upon the Word of God. The other thing, instead of capitalizing on those on the negative reports that we are having, it is also good time to have fellowship with your family. Probably we've not been having fellowship with our family, but it is the high time now. We take time. You have not had time to with your family. Can you take time to fellowship with your family? Can you have a family out? Can you have some books and sing a song of praise every day with your family? With your wife, with your children, you take time to sing and have time to fellowship with one another, to talk with one another. And when you are doing this, you can also reflect on what the Lord has done. Because it is not all bad. Where we are, we always say, the Lord is our evidence. Can you take time also to thank God and tell and also acknowledge what the Lord has done? If you have been married for 10 years, can you take time to give a testimony of what the Lord has done in 10 years? Can you remember the great things that the Lord has done? Can you remember the barriers that you have crossed through those years during your marriage? If you have been in business, you know where you have got through. There was a time your business was doing very well and then it went down. Can you also give a testimony? Can you also talk of the great things that the Lord has done? There was a time you were sick. It is time for a testimony. Praise the Lord. We can give a testimony one to another. Even you can call somebody and give a testimony. I remember when we were growing up, testimony was very important. This is time to give a testimony. And because the Lord is the same, when we used to remind ourselves that the Lord is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Even today, as we give our testimony in our fellowship, we can always remind ourselves the Lord who delivered us will also deliver us. We are not going to be dominated by fear. Let us listen to what the Lord is telling us. Let us remember what the Lord has done. And who has been with us in the past, He is going to be with us even in the future. The word I'm saying is that let us not be dominated with the fear. The Lord is with us. Praise the Lord. The other thing that we need to do, it is also to worship the Lord. Worship the Lord, and worshiping the Lord is the healing. We worship the Lord in diverse ways. We worship the Lord. Even at this time, it is a time even to worship the Lord. It is a time to worship the Lord. We give the sacrifice of praise before the Lord, the sacrifice of thanksgiving. It is the time even to offer our offering unto the Lord. It is the time to raise our tithes. So let us worship the Lord. Take time to worship the Lord with our givings, with our tongues, and the sacrifice of praise. There are diverse ways that we can worship the Lord. So it is time to worship the Lord. And when we do this, we are not concentrating on our fears. We are concentrating on the Lord, who is our strength and our legend. And this is our message today, that we want to take time because we want to learn to live by faith. And the Lord is going to help us. And I would want to say, as I finish, it is also a time of introspection. You tell the Lord to search your heart. How have you been living in your life? Because after all is said and done, After we have lived in this world, we have hope beyond the grave. And that is why we give our life to the Lord Jesus Christ. Have you ever given your life to the Lord Jesus Christ? Why do you go to church? Do you go to church just to go to be encouraged? Do you have faith in the Lord? There might be some who are listening to me today. You have never given your life to the Lord Jesus Christ. You have been a very good church member. You attend the service. You sing when others are singing. You give your offering when others are giving their offering. But you have never offered yourself to the Lord. Let me tell you, the Bible says that we should seek first the kingdom of God, and all these others shall be added unto us. It is time to seek the kingdom of God. It is time to tell God, come and take over my life. I've been living for myself for a long time. I've been looking and searching and joining for things that will come to an end. But I pray that may thy kingdom come in my life. May thy will be done in my life as it is in heaven. If you have never given your life to the Lord Jesus Christ, it is time to give your life to the Lord Jesus Christ. Tell the Lord, may thy kingdom come, and thy will be done. And when the kingdom of God comes in you, the God who is our refuge, our strength, he will come and dominate you, because in his kingdom, he will come and take charge of your life. Security. Even after you have been sick and your time come to an end, some of us are growing old and you are feeling you are growing old, and some are scared because they say the most vulnerable people and the people who are at least are those people that are growing old. And sometimes as you grow old, you become worried because you feel like you are living in a borrowed time. But I want to tell you, there is hope. And the worst disease is the disease of sin, because sin is the one that leads into eternal damnation. So we need God more than money. We need God more than even healing of our body. We need God more than the security of our life. We need God. And what we need at this time, it is God to come to our life. You can make the Lord Jesus as your personal Savior. The Bible says, he is the way, the truth, and the life. And no man comes to the Father, in John chapter 14, verse number 6, except by him. Do you know Lord Jesus Christ? He can give you, make you a new creature today. You can know the Lord personally. So that you'll be praying to him personally. You'll be going to him personally. You will have fellowship with him personally. In the name of Jesus. So this is the day that the Lord has made. And you are going to rejoice and be glad in it. Do you want to receive the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Savior? Do you want to receive the Lord Jesus as your personal Savior? This is the day that the Lord has made. And I want to pray with you this afternoon. I want to encourage you, my viewer who is watching, that the Lord is our strength. He is our refuge. And that is our message today. He is our most present help, even in this time of need. And he is going to carry us through the valley. Because in this valley, the valley is not a destination. We are just sojourner. It is a process. We are just going through it. We shall go through this valley, and this corona will be history. There was a time we were so much scared of HIV. These days we don't fear of HIV. It came and went. Yes, locusts came, they scared us so much. Today we are not so much focusing on locusts. Today we are focusing on corona. There was a time we had a long dry spell, and this dry spell came and left. We had a bumper harvest, and you can see things come and go. There are things that will always come and scare us. But the Lord is in control. The Lord is in control. That is what I want to tell us this afternoon. That the Lord is in control and is going to carry us through. And things will be back to normal. Our children will go back to school. We shall go back to our business. We shall continue with our life. We shall continue coming back to church. Because the Lord knows us. And He knows why we have to go through what we are going through. Therefore, I want to pray with us this afternoon. And let's bow down and pray. Whatever you have, I don't know what your need is. You might be sick in your body. I want to pray for those that are sick. And I want to remind you, the blood of Jesus is still fresh. For those that have not given their life to the Lord Jesus Christ, it is still fresh and it is washed us green as snow. Yes, the Lord is here even to solve the problems that we are going through. He is coming to solve the problems that we are coming through. He is coming to fight our battles. I don't know the kind of battles that you are going through. The Lord is there to fight your battles. I don't know the kind of depression. I don't know the depressing state that you are in. Probably, even as we think so much as Corona is not a big problem to you, but your family has been in locks. You have not been talking to your wife. You have not been talking to your children. You have not been talking to your husband. Oh, yes, your house probably, it has been like hell or not. I want to tell you, the Lord is coming to solve that problem. The Lord is coming to deliver you from that valley. The Lord is coming to take you out of that valley in the name of Jesus. Probably you have been having a financial crisis in your family. You have been lacking in one way or the other. The Lord is here and is hearing your cry. As I pray in the name of Jesus, the Lord is coming through for you. Probably you have been praying that the Lord may give you a job. You have been looking for a job for a long time. You are wondering, why are people getting jobs and I'm not getting a job? I want to tell you, yes, the Lord is doing a great thing. There's going to be a revival. Jobs are going to be created. There is going to be abundance, because the Bible says the Lord came that we may have. Jesus came that we may have life and have it more abundantly. Yes, there is going to be an abundance in our lives. In the name of Jesus, probably you've been having problems with your body. Your body has been sick. You've been going through pain. Oh, your blood pressure has been sagging. In the name of Jesus, you've been diabetic. Oh, in the name of Jesus, your back has been aching. Your head has been aching. In the name of Jesus, I'm declaring and decreeing that in the name of the Lord is touching your body. The Lord is touching your head. The Lord is touching your back. The Lord is touching your stomach. In the name of Jesus, there are those that have felt they have been living a barren life. You have been living a barren life. The Lord is terminating that barrenness. And the Lord is making you conceive once again. There are those things that have become barren in your life. The Lord is giving you. Yes, He's making your womb productive again. In the name of Jesus, the Lord is opening those wombs in the name of the Lord. Yes, the Lord is supplying. He is coming through for us in the name of the Lord. In the name of Jesus, you have been trusting God for a baby. You have been praying that may the Lord visit us and give us a child. The Lord is able even to give us a child, to give us children. For those that have been feeling like they have been in a valley of barrenness, the Lord is able to do it. Yes, the Lord is able. Is anything too difficult for the Lord? This afternoon I'm saying that which looks impossible possible with the Lord. In the name of the Lord, there is an operation that is going through. I don't know what the doctors have said. Probably they have said, I want to say that there is a surgery in the body. The Lord is doing a surgery. The Lord is removing that tumor. In the name of Jesus, the Lord is stabilizing your body. In the name of Jesus, you have been going through depression. Sitting as a now, oh, you are not going to be depressed again. Oh, yes, in the name of the Lord, something is happening. Something is happening in the spirit. Believe in me. Lift up your hand and pray to the Lord and say, it is happening. It is happening. It is happening. The Lord is doing it. The Lord is doing it. He is preparing a way for you. Yes, there are springs of water that are coming out of your desert. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, because you are doing it. Thank you, Lord, because you are hearing our cry. Thank you, Lord, for your visitation. Thank you, Lord, for your turning. Thank you for coming through for us. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Father, I'm praying for those that are under my voice this afternoon, and they have never given their life to the Lord Jesus Christ. I pray that this afternoon, Jehovah God, as they cry to you, I pray that you may start with them. Give them a new life in the name of Jesus. Because no one comes to you and you send them away. Oh Lord, there are those that have backslidden. They went back. They once trusted in you, but they no longer trust in you. They went back to sin. Jehovah, I pray, because you are God of a second chance, give them another chance, dear Lord. And as prodigal as the Father received the prodigal son, receive them again, oh Lord. Forgive their sins, oh God. In the name of Jesus, thank you, Lord, because you are saving your people. Thank you for your delivering them now. Thank you, Lord, for you have done it. Blessed be the name of the Lord. We worship you and we give you all the praise. Thank you for your heart. Thank you because you have done it. For I pray this, believing and trusting in Jesus' name. Amen. May God bless you. May God bless you. May God bless you. May God bless you. Have a sweet week and enjoy your time. And do not fear. Do not let fear dominate you. Let faith dominate your life and live by faith. I want to welcome Pastor Sammy to conclude our service this afternoon. And may God bless you. Amen.